All right, bunny. Lily? They like the bare table. Bare naked tables. You're a fine young cannibal. Out for my morning coffee. At 1 a.m. No, 1 p.m. 1 a.m. The sun came out one windy night. Oh, hey kitty. I sat there and I broke the bench, so I don't know how to fix it. It's like a little wobble. Oh god, it's coming right through there. Meow. Am I sitting in your spot? Shake the table with nothing on it. It's bare. I have to leave it bare. The cats love it with nothing on it. Do you like it with nothing on it? It's nude. A nude table. Cheers, cat. Oh god, yeah, cheers. Right. Oh, there's the other cat. Coming to the end of my week off, and I've left the thing that I want to do the least to the end. Let's go through these two black bags. So they've been there for ages. And I've made a pile of charity, only good for painting now, and stuff my son fit into, and I can't get rid of this. This is retro. What else remembers the Teleton? Yeah. Iconic, huh? Yeah. And then these are okay for use as well, so they probably go to charity. And I have to ask my son if that'll fit him. So that's in that pile over there. I don't know why I dread it so much. Just get it done, isn't it? So I'll have space beside my bed back again. Woohoo! And I might be able to actually play the guitar and not have it blocked by clothes. I
we have the fan pushes here.
Cappuccino
for
yeah, please. Could I have two little plates and a knife for divide that between?
Do you want that toaster?
Oh, can you toast that?
Yes.
Do you want the toaster?
I would.
Yeah, please, yeah.
Do you delight you?
Yeah.
purple sods. These are so cute. Aren't they very retro looking?
I like the flower.
I like the sugar. It's pink because I've seen the ice and sugar with pink label. The plain flower or the self-raising?
The red one.
Oh, the red one. I like the blue one. I like the red one too. But you need both sometimes. I know
it's
Frank
like
just gets this.
Red and olive is kind of associated. Yeah.
But like you wouldn't fit a big 2 kg pack in that.
No.
You'd only fit like 500 grams.
500 grams.
Yeah.
The English public house. My grandmother must have seen him, and she must have thought, well, there's my detective. Poirot was introduced to the world in 1920 as a World War I Belgian refugee in Agatha Christie's first book, The Mysterious Affair at Stiles.
What do you do now?
I'm the only man.
Never mind, I've talked to Wilson instead.
What am I doing? I'm going to install an escalator.
I'm really having a problem.
Oh, experiencing a little seasonal stress, Jill?
Yeah, my dad is having trouble adjusting to retirement. It's driving my mother crazy, so I tried to help, and now they're both really mad at me.
You got caught in the middle. That is a familial landmine, not mentioning Noel Nodo.
I'm sorry, I missed you. Get back. What did Wilson
say? Yes, I did.
Seasonal stress, Jill?
Yeah, my dad. dad is having trouble adjusting to retirement. It's driving my mother crazy, so I tried to help, and now they're both really mad at me.
You got caught in the middle. That is a familial landmine, not to mention a Noel no-no.
Of course, Tim told me not to get involved.
Yes, I did.
But is it really such a bad thing for me to try to help my parents?
Yes, it was.
Well, Jill, when parents are having problems, it's natural for a child, regardless of age, to want to help.
Did you hear that, Tim?
On the other hand, it's perfectly natural for parents to not want their children's help.
You hear that, Jill?
What are you saying? What am I supposed to do about my parents?
Well, I can tell you what they do in the newer tribe in Africa. A wise member of the tribe, usually an older newer, would counsel the disputing parties and help them resolve their differences.
So what I need is an objective third party.
Exactly.
Wilson, please.
I would love to, but I'm going to a Filipino Christmas party. Wait, the party's in the
Philippines. You're American.
Thanks anyway, Wilson. Have a nice trip.
Well, how about you, Tim? I think you would qualify as an objective third party.
Forget about it, Wilson. I'm the kind of guy that likes to stay at his ground.
He just hopped right back up. After falling off the roof. Oh, God, they look good.
So, what'd you get me for Christmas? Why? Because I want to know if I got you the same thing you got me. I didn't get you.
Are they eating off the icing or did
cinnamon raisins?
The raisins. Are they real children?
Sneaky bomb for breakfast tomorrow. You guys aren't sneaking any, are you?
No.
Why not? Nobody's looking.
Hey, girl.
Hey, you.
I'd have to watch this patent.
I have no interest in your battle with an 80-year-old proctologist.
Yeah, you guys probably gonna win anyway. You know how tough those old Navy guys are.
Did you say Navy?
Yes, I did.
No way we're going to let a Navy guy beat us.
All right, Colonel. I'll be your alpha. They've been beat your old doctor.
Now, let me see the enemy.
Watch your step. Across the street there, red brick, white trim. He's walking on the roof there.
We've got so many things up there, I can't see which one is Doc Johnson.
He's the one wearing the rubber gloves.